Hi everyone, and welcome back to Curious by Nature. I'm Allen, an entomologist, and your host for today's episode. Today, we're going to take a look at two huge insects you can find both in Animal Crossing and here at the museum, the common Morpho butterfly and the Atlas moth. So let's head to the Butterfly Haven and get a closer look. First up, we have a rather large and showy butterfly known in game as the Emperor butterfly. Its real-life counterpart is most likely the super shiny blue butterfly, Morpho menelaus, known as the menelaus morpho. And although we don't display the specific species at the museum, we do have a close relative, Morpho pilates, which is also known as the common morpho. Now, a small pet peeve of mine is that you'll see both of these referred to as the blue morpho, which isn't a super useful name, given that out of the around 30 species of morpho butterflies, most of them are blue. Nonetheless, what's remarkable about morpho butterflies are their magnificent fields of metallic blue color on their wings. So how do they get this brilliant blue? Well, as Blathers points out, if you look at the surface of a butterfly or moth's wing really closely, you can see it's just covered with tons of tiny colorful scales. The arrangement of these scales create color patterns. And on the underside of the common morpho, you can see how these scales form wavy lines and eye spot patterns. These scales here aren't metallic. Their colors come from chemical pigments within the scales, which are produced during metamorphosis. And the pigments work by absorbing and reflecting different wavelengths of light. For example, a yellow pigment works by reflecting wavelengths of yellow light while absorbing other wavelengths. Pigments can come in a wide variety of colors or be combined to make new colors, just like a painter with their palette. But what about the metallic blue on top? Blathers said they don't use dyes or pigments, and he's right, sort of. Instead of blue pigments, morpho scales make use of structural color. They contain tiny microstructures that bounce light rays back in such a way that some are scattered and some remain parallel to each other, but slightly out of phase. These light waves interfere with each other, which cancels out some colors and enhances others. The microstructures on their scales are spaced in such a way that the reflected light appears blue. That is also why when you move your head around and change your viewing angle of the wings, its color shifts slightly, giving it that metallic look. This is similar to how light reflected from the thin outer layer of a bubble creates a swirling rainbow effect, a phenomenon called thin layer interference. And for the most part, animals cannot make blue pigments and must rely on structural color to appear blue. Remember I mentioned that Blathers was sort of right that morpho butterflies do not use pigments on the top side of their wings? Well, they do. It's just not blue pigment. They do use melanin on the bright blue parts of their wings, which provides a dark base that enhances the overall blue color. If they did not use any pigments, their blue would have a lighter, sort of washed out appearance. Now, butterflies can combine structural colors together too, like they do pigments. For example, iridescent green could just come from one structural color, but at least for the emerald peacock swallowtail, Papilio palinurus, their scales reflect back both blue and yellow structural color, which together appear green when viewed by our eyes. Why are morphos blue? Doesn't that make them easier for predators to find them? Well, this color may actually work to help defend them. Remember, the undersides of both are cryptic, meaning that they can be hard to see in their natural environment. If a predator tries to sneak up on a perched morpho and grab it, when the morpho opens its wings to fly away, it produces a sudden blue flash, which may startle the predator, giving it just enough time to escape. As morpho butterflies fly around, you can also see this sort of blue flash that appears every time they open their wings and then disappears when they close them. This flashing, combined with their sophisticated flight acrobatics, makes them quite difficult to follow through the air. And these bright colors don't only protect morpho butterflies from being eaten, they also allow the butterflies to communicate with each other. Butterflies are typically diurnal, meaning they're active during the day when there's enough daylight to see color. And they have large eyes as well. Butterflies are rather visual creatures. Butterfly wing patterns can serve to help different species find each other and aid in courtship. Next, we have an even bigger insect, among the largest of all insects, and that's the Atlas moth. When captured, our villager shouts, "I bet it never gets lost." Although the in-game pun is referring to a book full of maps called an atlas, the moth is really named after the Titan Atlas from Greek mythology, who is condemned to hold up the whole world. Now, this species got its name due to its massive size, and that's one of the first things Blathers mentions about it for a reason. With a wingspan of about 10 inches, they really are among the largest moths in the world. They belong to a family of moths called Saturniidae, which are the royal silk moths, and many of them are large. Now, Blathers also mentioned that their wingtips look like snakes. Indeed, you can see what looks like a snake's profile with the mouth and eye, and the pattern along the wing's border can maybe look like a snake's body. When Atlas moths are disturbed and need to take off, they will vibrate their wings for a while, which helps prepare their muscles for flight. Some say this vibration makes the snake mimicry more convincing. Probably the most surprising thing about Atlas moths and other Saturniids is that they have such a short lifespan as an adult, only about 1 week. It's true, they emerge as a moth without functional mouth parts and they cannot eat. They have to gain all of their nutrition and energy as a caterpillar because a pupa can't eat either. Upon emerging, their clock starts ticking and they need to be able to find each other and mate and then lay eggs before they expire. And their body's morphology makes them incredibly efficient at doing just that. They use their large, feather-like antennae to smell and detect pheromones, which are basically chemical signals that can be used in many different ways. In this context, a female Atlas moth will release a plume of pheromones that a male Atlas moth can pick up from a distance. So Saturniids have big fuzzy antennae that provide plenty of surface area for picking up faint whiffs of these pheromones, and the male's antennae are even larger than the female's. When a male moth smells the pheromones, he'll fly upwind. If he loses the smell, he'll fly back and forth until he picks it up again, adjusts his flight path, and then continues this process until he finds her. An advantage of this smell-based navigation system is that it works even at night when there isn't much visible light. This matches with their active period in game, since you can only catch them at night, and they are nocturnal. After mating, but within their 1 week remaining lifespan as an adult, the Atlas moth females will still need to lay her eggs, and she'll find a sturdy surface to do that. The caterpillars are polyphagous, meaning they can eat a wide variety of plants, so the mother isn't so choosy on where she lays them. The truth is, Atlas moths are exceptional navigators, so perhaps they don't get lost easily, even without maps. Thank you for joining us for this special Animal Crossing episode. If you have questions about other Animal Crossing insects, or about Morphos or Atlas moths, be sure to drop them in the comments. In the meantime, if you want to learn more about how the Judy Istock Butterfly Haven works, or about other Animal Crossing insects, check out these videos. If you enjoyed today's video, be sure to like and subscribe so you never miss an episode, and we'll see you next time on Curious by Nature.